Hi everyone, it's Alistair again from Mango's Mapping, and today we're going to be talking to you about establishing a base station over an existing benchmark. So I use my trusty benchmark app to locate permanent survey marks when I'm out doing field work. And today we needed one in a suburban setting, so we found this one on the corner of a street. Using benchmark, I can download the government reports, the government sketches, and identify exactly where this benchmark should be on this corner. If you'd like to know more about the Benchmark app, take a look at the other videos in our series. We've got one specifically on the Benchmark app. In any case, I know that it should be around here somewhere, and you can see there's a little paint marking here on the concrete that indicates the location of something. And feeling around in here, we can actually see that there's a benchmark, a permanent survey mark down here. So there it is, 53524. And you can see right in the middle there, there's the centre mark that we'll centre our tri-brack on to make sure that we've got our base station nice and level directly over the top of this benchmark. So the first thing we need to do is to establish a safe work site. To do that, we'll pop out a few witch's hats, we'll chuck a few behind the car, and we'll chuck a couple more down around the benchmark itself. When working with tripods, I really like to use a tripod that has a dual locking system. So it has a quick release clamp at the top that allows you to quickly level your tripod, and it has locking screws at the bottom that you can use to ensure that your tripod doesn't move during your survey session. And as a general rule, once I've set up my base station, I'll take my rover and I'll go and occupy another benchmark to make sure that my coordinates are coming out and that I don't have any gross errors in the propagation of my data based on incorrect setup. I'll do that both at the beginning and at the end of my survey session, sometimes during the day as well, just to have a sense of assurance that nothing's changed during the day with regards to the setup of my base that would lead to incorrect observations on my rover. So in my toolbox here, I've got a number of different tools that I use, including a measuring tape to determine our vertical offset above the base station, and a number of other bits and bobs that we might need throughout the day as we conduct our survey work. So today we're going to be using a tri-brack and tri-brack adapter that contains an optical plummet. And the optical plummet, used in conjunction with the bubble level on top and the leveling screws on the side, allow us to set up the tri-brack in a way that is both perfectly level and centered directly above the permanent survey mark below the tripod. So what I will do now is just approximately get this level and then use my optical plummet to swivel my legs around to get it so that it is more or less centered above the permanent survey mark. At that point, I'll just insert these tripod legs into the ground to give them a good grip on the earth, reduce the chance of them moving during the day. And you can see that we're really not level here. So we'll just drop that down so that we're a bit closer to level and see how we're looking. And in here, I've got fine adjustment screws for both the visibility of the ground and the visibility of the target above the mark. So looking through here, I can see the target and the surface down on the ground so that I can move this around and have it perfectly centered. We're off by about 10 mil. Firstly, we'll just adjust our levels. Now, the trick when you're leveling is to start off with your leveling screws in approximately the center, and many tri-backs contain a little groove in the center. If I wind this up, you can have a closer look and see that little groove. And that little groove allows you to know when you've got these roughly in the middle of your tri-brack. So having all of those approximately in the middle gives you a fair bit of play in both directions. Okay, so we're just in the middle of levelling our tri-brack, and you know what's happened? The local contractor's rocked up, and he's here to cut the grass on the nature strip out the front. And it's a great example of how things can go a little bit south when you're trying to set up a base station, and an example of how your base station can be disturbed during the middle of your survey sessions. I had a quick chat with Norm from Taylor's Tree Lopping that's here to do some contract lawn mowing for Pat, the lady that lives on the corner. Anyway, We said to Norm we were happy to move out of the way and let him get his thing done, and then we could work without his noise. And you know what? He's actually offered to pop off to another block, and he's going to come back and do this one after his little job around the corner. So we're going to be able to finish off this segment today without a lawnmower in the background or flying blades of grass. So we were just in the process of finalising the levelling on our tri-brack. So as I indicated, you can use your levelling screws to shift the bubble into the centre of the spirit bubble on the tri-brack. And the trick to it, as taught to me by a retired surveyor, is to move the levelling screws two at a time in equal and opposite directions and half as much as you think you need to. And that tends to allow the bubble to get to where it needs to go. Now I can see the bubble's a little high on this side, so I need to lower this side and raise this side. So I'm going to rotate the lowering side anti-clockwise and the side I want raised clockwise in equal and opposite directions and half as much as I think I need to. And as I slowly do that, I can see the bubble shift across so that it's centered along that axis. Okay, so you can see that we've now got it so that the bubble is more or less centered exactly in the middle of the tri-brack. Once again, we'll just check to make sure that we're still centered over the top of the PSM. And yes, indeed we are. We've got a bullseye there. So we're ready to go with getting our receiver up and running. So today we're going to establish our base station on top of this benchmark and use that to broadcast a correction to our rover so we get survey grade positionings on our rover. To minimise the potential for multipathing, I'm just going to add a small GNSS extension pole to this tripod to just bring it up a little bit and to allow maximum sky view when the surrounding houses are taken into account. So I've got a 500mm extension pole here. These are available on the MapGear website. And screwing that in gives me my elevated position for my base. So I can now take my base and I'm going to start by turning this one on. Now it's got a rover sticker on it, but the beauty of the Emlid hardware is that it can be both rover and base with a simple flick of a soft switch inside the reach view application. So I'm going to attach my LoRA antenna. Now this is an important point. If you're planning to use a LoRA antenna, you will need at the very least a small extension pole on your tri-brack, otherwise you won't have clearance for your antenna. There are shorter extension poles also available on the MapGear website and for sale from Mango's Mapping. So we've set up our base on our pole, on our tripod above our permanent survey mark. What we have to do now is to configure the receiver to broadcast corrections via LoRA so that our rover can pick it up. So the first thing we need to do is to jump on and make sure that we are connected to the relevant Wi-Fi network, which indeed we are. So once we're connected to the right Wi-Fi network that the receiver itself is broadcasting, we can then jump into the view of Reach View 3, go to the receivers tab, and refresh your view of receivers. You can see that we're already connected to demo 11. So we can now head into the settings tab. We need to make sure that our corrections output is on. So here we are broadcasting at 920 megahertz, 911 kilobits per second is the air data rate. And we'll need to make sure that those two settings are the same in our rover that we're using today as well. And once we've got that done, we can jump down into our base mode setting and you can either coordinate from your known point, which we'll do today, a manual coordinate, or you can connect to an existing correction source like NTRIP or a radio if you like, and coordinate the base from that if you were to traverse. Today, however, we're going to enter manual coordinates, and you can manually enter them in here if you're aware of them, and please be aware that you need to use your ellipsoidal, not your geoidal height of your benchmark. Today, though, we're going to choose a point that we've got sitting in an existing project, and that allows us to just apply that point, and it's going to automatically consume that point and use it as the coordinates for this benchmark. In addition to inputting the coordinates for the benchmark, we also need to include the height of the antenna. Now, we measured this just a little earlier, and it's 1.374 metres from the top of the PSM to the base of the pole here. And we use that as a nice, neat point that we can measure to. And we know that there's about 1 millimeter of additional height introduced by measuring on a slight angle. So we're going to compensate by subtracting 1 mil from that. So we're looking at 1.373 mil. We're going to add 500 mil for our GNSS extension pole. So that means that our antenna height today is going to be 1.873 meters in height. And what you'll see is once we save that, the antenna height actually shows a little bit higher again. And that's because the receiver is also applying the offset from the antenna reference point through to the height of the receiver. So we've got the height of the receiver, the 500 mils here, the 1.373 meters down to the center of the permanent survey mark. And collectively that makes up the antenna height that sits on top of the elevation of the permanent survey mark itself. So if we hit save there, we've now got the base coordinates configured and we've got the correction output active, broadcasting a correction via the LoRA radio. And finally, we'll just jump into our GNSS settings, and by default, all of the constellations are selected. And we're just gonna make sure that that is the case, because we do like to have them all on. And you can see that they're all on. We've got our other GNSS settings in an appropriate manner, so we can leave all of those. I guess the only other thing that we can do with our base mode is to jump down and check out the RTCM messages that are being broadcast. So that's going to load the RTCM3 messages dialog, and in that we can make sure that we're satisfied with the frequency at which all of the GPS messages are being broadcast. Now they're all set on 0.5 of a hertz, which is once every 2 seconds. But from experience, I know that I can take our American constellation, the GPS constellation, and apply that at 1 hertz, which means that it's broadcasting a correction every second. And all of that information can be broadcast with the radio settings that we've got. If we were to increase the frequency of the other corrections up to every second as well, we would find that we'd need to increase the air data rate of the radio. And that's great for short baseline jobs, but when the length of the baseline between your base and your rover is extended, you do need to wind the air data rate back to be able to project the corrections further. So there you go, that's the process that we go through to have our receiver broadcasting a correction. So you can see that this receiver is observing 43 satellites currently. It doesn't have a solution because it isn't receiving a correction itself, but that's just fine. We know where it is because of the coordinates of that base mark. We've put that in there. It's using all of that information to broadcast the corrections output, and we are now ready to get to work with our rover. And when we do that, the first thing we'll do is a quality check on another known coordinate to make sure that we don't have any gross errors in our setup that mean that our rover is broadcasting incorrect settings. We want to make sure that that's good both at the beginning of the day and at the end of the day. Sometimes for a little peace of mind, you might even go and occupy a known point during your day as well to ensure that your base hasn't been disturbed by lawn mowers or anything else that might interrupt the precision of the corrections that are being broadcast. So that just about wraps it up for today. So if you like this video, please hit the like button below, subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you next time. Thank you very much.